When we were working with Mycoplasma pneumoniae, we needed to do something called fulfilling Koch's postulates. Robert Koch, a German scientist, established some principles in respect to how you prove that a disease is caused by a particular agent. And his rules went something like this. Of course, you must isolate the agent and identify it first. Then you must inoculate it into an appropriate animal, and this, in some cases, as with M. pneumoniae, a human. And then you must prove that a disease is produced. And then you must isolate the organism from the disease and prove that you have the same organism. Those are Koch's postulates. So Bob Chanek and I had an opportunity to do this because in that era, there were at the clinical center in Bethesda, prisoner, quote, volunteers, end quote, federal prisoner volunteers on whom experiments were done. In our case, it was not a serious breach of any ethical consideration, in my judgment, because what we did was to take the culture that I had discovered, grow up the mycoplasmas in a solution, and instill it into the nares, into the nose of prisoner volunteers, hoping to reproduce primary atypical pneumonia. Now, that wasn't a fatal disease, if indeed the prisoners came down with it, because we could treat it immediately with antibiotics and that would be the end of it. It turned out that the culture that my culture was negative. It did not produce a disease. After I had, by this time, isolated a fresh culture of Mycoplasma pneumoniae from a patient at University of Pennsylvania and grew that up, that one did produce disease. The reason the first one failed is a very well-known phenomenon, and that is when a microorganism that produces some pathogenicity is passaged many, many times, as this agent had been by Monroe Eaton and Bob Chanek, that it will lose its disease-producing capability. And apparently that's what happened. So my strain, although it has been deposited in a central repository for microorganisms in the United States called the American Type Culture Collection, and in the United Kingdom and Germany and several other countries, that strain did not produce disease for the reasons that I mentioned. And so the ethical considerations, as you can see, were quite different. No committee approval was required, as is required today.